Well, good morning, beloved, and happy Thursday. I want to tell you something. God loves you with an everlasting love, and He is with you always, and He is with you now, and through Jesus Christ, leading you and us through this difficult time that we're in, and we're all in it, and we're all keeping our eyes on Jesus, watching Him, waiting for Him, and talking to Him. That's what prayer is. Prayer is fellowship with God. We're looking at those two words this week, pray and love. Pray and love. Yesterday we looked at love, and I want to talk about prayer today, because when you pray, that's the most basic, elementary expression of faith that you have. And you can thank God for the faith that you have. And during a difficult time, it's hard to pray, especially when it's grievous. And we're in a season of grief right now with this virus, and there's so much uncertainty that goes with that. And so we are praying, but when you're in a time of grief, you really can't pray many words. That's been my experience anyway. It's just one of these times that, like we're in right now, where you put your head on the pillow at night and you only have two words that you can pray. Oh, God. Oh, God. And just weep as you pray and go to sleep with that two-word prayer. Well, we're in that kind of a time right now. But the Bible teaches us that when we're in that time of prayer, when we don't have words to pray, the Holy Spirit, Romans 8:26, that the Holy Spirit groans with us with words that are deeper than any words that we could ever have. Amen. And He intercedes for us with that deeper groaning than even we have. Interceding, asking the Father for the strength and His presence, most of all, for assurance that He is with us in that time. And beloved, He is with us in this season we're in right now. And He will get us through, and we'll come out with a stronger faith. You know, the book of Job talks about this kind of thing. And, you know, Job started out with what we would call a proprietary faith. He kind of owned it. He was in control. Everything was going great. He had a routine, and things couldn't even get better. And then the test came, and he didn't know. It was suddenly, and he lost everything except his life and his faith. And that's when his faith became desperate. And it is during those difficult times where our faith goes from we're in control and everything is okay and I love this life, and all of a sudden I'm just hanging on and praying that two-word prayer, oh God, and a desperate faith. Beloved, a desperate faith leads to a sufficient faith, where you come out the other side and you realize what I have in my relationship with God is more than enough. More than enough. And you realize my faith was not holding on to God. I trust that He was holding on to me, because here we are on the other side of it now. And beloved, we're going to the other side of this together with God, and we're going to end. The outcome of it is a sufficient faith, so much stronger than ever before. But in the meantime, we've got to struggle through with short, deep, desperate prayer of faith, knowing that the Holy Spirit is groaning even deeper than we are with words that we don't even have to assure us that He is with us and He is going to get us through victoriously with a stronger faith, a sufficient faith for His glory and our joy and strength. Amen. Let's pray for that right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, how grateful we are. Help us in these days, oh God. Help us in these days. Help us not to be led astray with criticism of other people, especially the family of God. Good grief. God, help us to encourage one another and to pray for one another. And even when we don't even have words to pray, thank you, Holy Spirit, that you are interceding for us with deeper groans than we even have, to assure us that your plan is perfect, that you are good, and that you're forming Christ in us. Lord Jesus, be our strength today, our hope and joy, is our prayer in the name which is above every name. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen and hallelujah.